I'm Dylan Elkins.
And I'm Daquisha, and you're watching LHS News Magazine.
It's homecoming week again, and it's Tropical Tuesday.
We sent our news crew out to get all the juicy events this week.
Such as the new crowning of the homecoming queen, Powerpuff Volleyball. And we also have other dress-up days this week. Stay tuned.
Because today, this is school's fair week, and today is Safari Day. Are you in the football team?
No, I'm not.
What do you think about LC?
They're going down.
They're going down. Are you playing the game? Go to the game?
Yes.
Are you going with friends, family?
I'm going to meet my friends. My sister and my dad should be coming as well.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
What grade are you in?
11th grade. I'm a freshman.
How much beer do you have?
Why? We're cheerleaders! Woo!
What do you think about LC?
They have no spirit and they suck.
We hate them.
You hate them?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Orange is a poopy color.
No, go balls.
Yeah, go balls.
Are you planning to go to the game?
We're cheering at the game.
So you're going?
Yeah, we got spirit.
Definitely. Woo! Are you going with the cheerleader team?
Yeah.
Cheerleader
team. We're riding the bus.
Yeah.
Wait, actually, no. It's here.
Never mind. The game is here.
You're
gonna lose. We're gonna win. You're gonna get 0 points, and we're gonna get 100. So be ready.
You heard it.
Be ready.
Later. Thank you for your time.
Heard it here first. On LHS News Report. Today's been a Safari Day. See you next time.
Hi, I'm Taylor Beatty with LHS News. I'm here at Loudon High School to experience Disney versus Marvel Day.
I'm Marvel. Obviously, Spider-Man, my life role model, because like I just want to live my life like Spider-Man lives his life, like on the wall, crawling up it.
I'm Kim Disney. I am Princess Jasmine. So our class could win, and I love Disney. The juniors, duh.
I'm dressed up as Robin from the Disney movie Robin. Hood. Robin Hood. She's Robin Girl, I'm Robin Hood, man.
Girl version of Robin Hood.
Well, I was kind of forced, but she went to the costume store, and this is what they had, so this is what we are. I mean, obviously it's going to be the juniors, because we're the best at everything.
I'm Marvel, dressed up as Captain America. He's my favorite superhero.
I'm a Dalmatian. A bunch of my friends were.
Hello, my name is Selena Matria at LHS News. Today we are covering Disney vs. Marvel Day.
I'm looking forward to Pink Day, because to me that's the most important day that we have on Friday.
Friday, because we're going to kick Howard's butt.
The Country vs. Country Club.
Because I like to show spirit.
Yay! The show School Spirit.
Participate. I like to participate.
I like to show school spirit, and it's just fun to get involved with.
School spirit for like ever, because I've done it since my freshman year.
Forever.
Since LHS, it's been LHS.
Mouse Club, we'll have fun, we'll meet new faces.
Mimi Mouse, and because she's my favorite Disney character.
Wonder Woman, because she's full of wonders.
Well, obviously, I'm Mickey Mouse, and this is my wife, Minnie. Hi, Minnie.
Hi, Minnie.
Hey. Okay.
Good.
I got the idea from Pinterest.
Callie Party.
I got the idea from this creative.
Honestly, my wife got it on Pinterest.
I'm Selena here at LHS News. Thank you.
Service Dogs.
Smoky Mountain Service Dogs is a nonprofit organization that provides service dogs for disabled veterans with a disability in mobility. So they provide, the veteran must have a mobility disability in order for them to qualify for a service dog through Smoky Mountain Service Dogs.
Chairperson for Smoky Mountain Service Dogs, and what we do is provide mobility assistance service dogs to veterans that need that type of assistance, that come back and maybe have suffered traumatic brain injury, and they have balance issues, or maybe they lost limbs and have balance issues. We show you today what these wonderful dogs do for them. I'd like to introduce, before I show you this, I'll show you Billy, tell you about Billy Dennis. Yeah. I mean, yes, I'm an Army guy, Vietnam era veteran. Dennis is a Vietnam veteran, and he has with him today this yellow lab, Billy. Billy's had about 1,600 hours of training over 2 years. Part of our process is we do a home visit on the veteran, because we've got to know, are there steps in the house, do they have other animals, are those animals a problem? Can you exercise and take care of our dog? Because when we give them a dog, at the end of our process, the it's about $23,000-$25,000, like giving them a car. And we love our dogs, but we got to be sure this is the right thing to do and that they can take care of our dogs.
Yes, he's standing up and see.
Yeah. Yes.
How about that? Pick a credit card up off his floor and hand it to him. Risk falling. Every dog we have, pick it up and put it on the counter. They're not normal to do it. Or it's another story.
271.
Fine.
Yes.
Go find it. Find your phone.
Now, that doesn't look like much, but you'd be sitting in your chair, the phone's away from you, you have the prosthetics off, you'd want somebody to get a phone for you. This dog can find a phone in a house, if I just say phone, it doesn't have to be ringing, she'll be around hunting everywhere until she finds that phone and brings it to me. Cane, I can tell her cane, she'll go find it. Light switches.
Okay, if you go to Smoky Mountain, servicedogs.org, you will be able to see there are a variety of ways that you can donate monetarily.
My name is Courtney Moore from LHS News. Today we're going to be covering dress code and see the different sides and perspectives from students and teachers.
Why not do you think we should have dress code?
I think we need a dress code because I don't think kids always make the right decision, and so if we have guidelines, then they have something to base their decision on.
What would you consider breaking dress code?
I would consider showing too much skin. Certainly shirts that have logos that are not appropriate for schools, such as alcohol and gangs and things like that.
How do you feel about us having different dress codes from different schools?
I think it's a good idea for schools to kind of develop their own culture, and this gives each school an individuality, sort of.
Do you feel that our school dress code is sexist?
Not really. No, I think there's, within our culture, there are certain things that girls tend to go too far with and certain things that boys go too far with.
Why or why not do you think we should have dress code?
Well, I think we need a dress code because some students dress in ways that interfere with education.
What would you consider breaking dress code?
Wearing clothes that's too revealing. And we do have rules here. Like the holes in the jeans are not that revealing, but it's against the rules, so that's breaking dress code.
How do you feel about us having different dress codes from different schools?
Within the county or from school to school?
School to school, mainly.
I think you have everybody's individuals, different communities are different, so you do need different dress codes.
Do you feel that our school dress code is sexist?
No.
Why?
Well, when I think about it, I can't think of any rule that's, other than the cleavage rule, that applies to one sex or the other.
Would you rather have dress code or uniforms?
Actually, I kind of like uniforms because how much time would it save us all if we knew exactly what we were going to wear in the morning? And then you know exactly what clothes you need, then we spend a lot of money on our clothes, and if everybody were wearing the same thing,
yeah,
it makes it a little easier.
Would you rather have dress code or uniforms?
I think uniforms would be easier.
Why?
Personally. Well, then nobody has to worry about what to wear, and nobody has to worry about whether they're being in style, and I think in the end it would probably be cheaper for the most kids to do that, and it's more uniform, obviously.
Why or why not do you think we should have dress code?
I think we should have dress code because it's like, it's something we have to do.
What would you consider breaking dress code?
Like really short shorts or no sleeve shirts or, you know, being like naked or something like that.
How do you feel about us having a different dress code from different schools?
Wait, what?
How do you feel about us having different dress codes from different schools?
Well, I mean, that sucks. Because like other school can like not be in the right dress code and they like breaking rules or things like that.
Do you feel that our school dress code is sexist?
Well, yeah, because like girls, I mean, guys have like less rules and all that.
Do you think it's fair that teachers are allowed to break dress code?
No, like, they shouldn't break their rules.
Would you rather have dress code or uniforms?
Dress code.
Why?
Because uniforms are like, negated.
Would you consider breaking dress code?
Well, it's not our fault, you know, that the boys do think, you know, like in a wrong way. But then there is, in a way, our fault because sometimes we can take it a little too far.
How do you feel about us having different dress codes from different schools?
There's some that do allow like holes on their pants and there are others who don't.
Do you feel that our dress code is sexist?
In a way, yes.
Why?
Because if guys have holes on their jeans, it's not really considered bad for other people. But then a girl has holes on their jeans and they say something about it.
Would you rather have dress code or uniforms?
Uniforms.
Why?
That way everyone would be dressing the same and there wouldn't be anything bad to say about it.
This is LHS News. I'm Courtney Mua. Thank you.
Well, you heard it here first, here at LHS News Magazine.
I'm Doc Leisha.
And I'm Dylan Evans, here at
Redskin Country.